to keep you covered. I'm not covered today by my stock portfolio. I'm not covered today by the money I have in the bank. I'm not covered today by who I'm married to. I'm not covered today by the car I drive, or where I went to school, or where I live, or what kind of suit I wear. Don't cover me. Sisters, the Maybelline makeup on your face don't cover you. The weave in your hair don't cover you. If you're covered today, it ought to be by the blood of Jesus Christ. I'm covered because I'm a child of God. I'm covered because I've been baptized for the remission or removal. I've been washed. I've been cleansed. I've been purged in the blood. The Bible says, though our sins be as scarlet, we have been washed white by the blood of Jesus Christ. See, you've been given the wrong full credit. Your boss may have given you a job, but Jesus opened the way. Your mama may have given you birth, but through Jesus you were born again. You may have your daddy's pedigree or DNA, but you ought to have Jesus' blood. Your car may have driven you over here, but whether you have a GPS or not, God navigated the spirit system. Your love may have went off this morning, but it was God that woke you up. Don't give the wrong person the credit for what God has done. We ought to shout on the fact that we're covered. You see, sometimes we shout on the wrong thing. Get on my nerve, our folk will get a new car and shout. You hear about somebody got a new house? We shout. We'll shout on our bling bling and our ching ching. We'll shout on our material, our tangible blessings. But I came by to tell you today, what Christians ought to do is shout because you've been covered by the blood of Jesus. Why should I shout on this shield, preacher? Well, there's some immutable facts. Let me take you by the schoolhouse before I shout you real fast. We covered, David says, by the shield of God. The shield he speaks of in Roman days was the large buckler type shield. They actually carried two shields in warfare. One shield was a small, miniature, microscopic, if you will, one they had on their wrist. And that was for a close combat to divert a dagger or a close stab from a knife. But the buckler was considered to be the large shield that he carried on his arm. And this shield was some 5 feet high and 2 feet wide. Now, why you ought to shout about this metaphor, about this allegorious exposition that David has given us? And because the shield was big enough to cover the whole man. Every part and every aspect of the short soldier was covered by the shield. Well, you don't want to shout on that. Well, maybe part two will help. Not only was it able to cover the whole man, but the shield, the buckler, had the ability to connect with other shields. Y'all on the rim door. It had grooves and ridges inside, and it was able to connect with other shields. See, Roman soldiers marched in the war in column formation. And when their formidable foes would fire arrows and javelins at the legion of soldiers, what they would do is lock their shields with their other soldiers' shields. They locked shields one with another because they recognized something that the body of Christ has yet to recognize. And that is that we can do together that which we cannot do in the
preaching.
You see, when you look over history, you find that there are things you can do together that you can't do by yourself. Matter of fact, if you scan history, both biblical and secular, you'll find that any significant thing accomplished was accomplished when they were paired up with somebody else. Moses had Joshua. Yeah. Paul had Silas. Ruth had Noemi. David had Jonathan. Yeah. Batman had Robert. Hagner had Lisa. Butch Cassidy had the Sundance Kid. Starsky had Hutch. Peaches had her. I'm going old school on you. In Ephesians 6 and verse 11, that we all ought to put on the whole armor of God, that we may be able to withstand the wiles of the devil. He said we ought to put on the breastplate of righteousness. We ought to shod our feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Paul said we ought to gird up our loins with truth. Paul said we ought to put on the helmet of salvation. Our right hand, we ought to have the sword of the Spirit, but in our left hand, the shield of faith. And make a notation, Paul said, above all, you ought to have the shield of faith. My brothers and sisters, if we're going to stand against the devil, we ought not, need not, cannot stand by ourselves. Right. Vicki Wines has messed a lot of us up. Because in her lyrical expression, she said, as long as I got King Jesus, I don't need nobody else. But I got news for you. If you're living here in this world, on this earth, in this country, dealing with the issues with you, you're going to need somebody. The pressure is too great. I heard Mary J. say years ago, you've been too strong for too long. There will come a time when you need to connect with somebody else. I came here to tell you today, I'm covered. By the blood of Jesus. I'm covered